What is the best mini PC for a home theater? For that matter, what is a mini PC? Welcome to the Mini PC Tech Channel, where we talk about everything mini PC. This is Mike, your host today. We're looking at mini PC for home theater. It can take streaming to the next level. Stay with us because we're also giving you our picks to get you started shopping for mini PCs. If you like videos like these, remember to subscribe to find out when new videos come out. If you want more information, check on the link to our blog post in the description. So, what is a mini PC? A mini PC is a small form factor computer with the same components as its larger cousins, the laptop or desktop. But wait! Aren't computers going to take up a lot of space? And aren't they hard to use? And aren't they expensive? The mini PC is usually less expensive than its bigger cousins. You can find mini PCs out there for under $100. But what we are looking at here are in the $200 to $1,000 range to get the kind of performance you need. That's still not too bad if you have a $3,000 or more home entertainment system. When you add up the cost of good speakers, the TV, and any other accessories, that's not hard to do. The mini PC doesn't take up a lot of space. It is generally under 3 pounds and takes up little space. Sometimes none because some of these mount behind a TV or monitor. So they don't take up a lot of space. Okay, so there must be a downside to this, right? Well, if you put all those components in a small box like that, it can generate more heat, and it may suffer from fan noise. For a home entertainment system, that's not great. But you can find quiet mini PCs that don't run hot, or isolate them to deaden the noise if they do. Also, to put all those components in a small space, everything is usually soldered in place so you can't easily upgrade or change anything. You usually get what you pay for, but some do have upgrade options. Yes, computers can be hard to use. But there are remote controls that you can use if that works for your applications. If it doesn't, then at least most people are familiar with Windows or Mac operating systems. Mostly point and click. But we'll try to avoid even that. So how would you use a mini PC in a home theater? First obvious answer is, to store stuff. If you have a collection of videos, you can store them locally and get what you want when you want it. This is the least costly of all systems because the server will just stream to an application like Plex and you don't need to worry about speed or resolution or stuff like that. Second is to stream services that aren't available on your smart TV. For example, my cable provider has a Roku app, but it's just awful. A better solution would be to run a browser on my mini PC and run it to the smart TV. That requires that the smart TV has the speed and resolution to be able to get the best picture possible to the smart TV. That doesn't mean the absolute best. After all, if your TV only supports 4K at 60Hz, it doesn't matter that the PC supports 8K. So what do you need for the mini PC? You need four things: processor speed, memory, storage, and graphics. What you need depends on how good the rest of your system is. If it's just for a media server, you need lots of storage, a decent processor, and a good amount of memory. It really depends on your program. Plex, as an example, will run on an i3 or greater, which is pretty much anything out there. I would err and get at least an i5. Make it an i7 if it needs to stream to multiple TVs. For storage, that really depends on what you have. You'll have to figure that out. But know that most machines in that range come as either 256GB, 512GB, or 1TB. At some point, you may need to opt for a network-attached server which can go well above 10TB if you need it. Now let's look at the more common case, where the mini PC is using the smart TV as a monitor for the mini PC. You have the same considerations, but it gets more complex. The CPU, memory, and graphics will vary depending on your goals. The storage is really depending on whether and how much media you will have on the computer. Before you figure out what you need, you have to ask yourself, how many TVs and/or monitors do I need and what is their resolution? typically they will be 4K at 60 Hz. But some are up to 240 Hz and others are 8K at 60 Hz. You also may want to look at if it's lower cost to have a mini PC on each display, or if there are groups of displays in a room, maybe per room. But let's look at what we need. What you need depends on the goals. For one or two 4K 60Hz displays, you will only need a machine with 8GB of RAM, i7 or better, with standard graphics. Just make sure the computer has enough RAM. In all cases, the RAM should be always at least DDR4, DDR5 is better, but more costly and probably only important when we talk about more than 3 displays or an 8K display. For 60Hz dual displays, the processor should be at least an i5 or equivalent that can run at least 2 GHz with at least 4 cores. That will give it the power it needs to coordinate the games fast enough to give you a good experience. You shouldn't need to worry about the graphics, as even the Intel UHD card or equivalent should work. More important that the machine support the number of 4K monitors that you need. Some very low-cost machines on support 1-in-a-second low-resolution VGA monitor. So if you need dual monitors, be sure the machine will support it. A clue is that it has at least one HDMI port and either a second HDMI or a DisplayPort connector. For one or more higher resolution 4K displays, you need a better graphics card, a better processor, and more memory. At least a Radeon 680M graphics card or equivalent is best. At least an i7 processor or equivalent with 4 cores and at least 3 GHz. And 16GB of RAM will allow you to support 2 or more 4K displays comfortably. Finally, the machine needs to be spec'd to run the number and types of monitors you need. With that behind us, let's dive into 5 mini PCs that would be great for A. We have the Mac Mini, the Minisforum UN690S, the Beelink S12, the GMKTECK1, and the NUC12 Enthusiast. We have provided links to each one below this video in the description. Let's start with the Mac Mini. We actually are picking it twice. Once for the M2, and once for the M2 Pro. The M2 will easily handle 2 60Hz 4K displays. In fact, Apple says one of the displays can be 5K, which I believe is only available as an Apple display. The M2 Pro will handle 3 simultaneous displays at 4K, or possibly one 8K display. I say possibly because I can't find anything definitive on the Apple site, but I found people were able to make this work if you search around YouTube. I reference one of the videos on my blog post that I reference in the description below. So is this the ideal mini PC for an entertainment center? Probably not, unless you are an Apple fan. It isn't the best, but it's a Mac, and for a lot of people that's important because it works well with the rest of their Apple universe. Next, we have the Beelink S12 Pro Mini. It's small, and can be hidden behind a display with a VESA mount, so takes up virtually no space. It will easily run 2 4K displays at 60Hz, and it can act as a small media server, as people have used it successfully with Plex. The 4 USB ports will allow you to add external drives if needed. There are complaints, but people also like the customer service, so that can make this low price option work with a little patience on your part. Next, we have the Minisforum UM690S. This is a little more expensive than the lower priced Mac Mini. But it handles up to 3 displays. 2 4K and 1 8K. With a Ryzen 9 processor, 32GB of RAM, and 512GB of storage, it's up to the task. The Radeon 680M graphics card works, but opinions vary as to whether this will double as a top-notch gaming machine. But for streaming, you should love it. The Minisforum UM690S comes with Windows 11, but if you're so inclined, users report it can run Linux. Next, we have the GMK-TECK1 Mini. It has the same specs as our top pick for the CPU and memory. The disk is a bit larger at 2 TB, and it also supports 3 displays, including one at 8K. Finally, we have the Intel NUC12 Enthusiast Mini PC. It is a little more expensive than the others. The CPU is more powerful at 14 cores at up to 4.7 GHz. And it has a top-notch graphics card with the Intel Arc. The internal storage can be expanded with 2 more SSD drives. Where it really outperforms, it supports up to 5 4K displays, one of which can be 8K. So this can truly be an entertainment hub for the entire house. And people love it as a gaming PC for the price. So what have we talked about? We've told you what to look for in a good entertainment mini PC. CPU speed, memory, and graphics are the 3 most important specs. A mini PC doesn't take up a lot of space on the floor or in your wallet. And it can enhance your system using mostly remote controls or mouse clicks.
We've given you 5 options of mini PCs to look at for the home entertainment center. Links are provided in the description below. We told you what to look for in a mini PC and how these 5 minis meet those requirements. If you found one or more that may work for you, the links are in the description. If you found this guide helpful, please like, share, and subscribe for more tech insights.
Don't forget to check out our website for in-depth reviews and discussions. The link is in the description below.